seems like getting a grip on the shot.
You definitely get better.
No pain, no gain.
That's it.
Only 2 minutes left. Oh.
Another 5 minutes. The dog looks now. I thought I'd be tiring you all, but you're picking up your eating and bloody shit.
Oh shit, you're getting worse, so
you're up in a nightmare. You're gonna try to pick up. Come on, just let it go in there.
What's up guys, it's Scott, your boxer mind. For all of you out there, I'm sure you know, but if you don't, I'm going to repeat it. Remember these words. Sparring is key to boxing. It's the most important thing you can do to get good at boxing. It's to spar. Okay, the bag, skipping, shadow boxing, everything counts. You need to do it all. You need to do it all well, but if you need to make sure you're spending enough time each week sparring, okay? Get someone who's willing to put in the time with you sparring. Okay, if you notice me and my sparring partner Nate here, we're doing 30 minute spars, 35 minute spars. We just set a timer, 30 minute spar, you know? It's good because it pushes us, it's improving our fitness, it's making us comfortable with sparring. A lot of people, they go to the gym and the coach throws them in and they're all tense and they're scared. That's not how to get good at boxing, you know. The coach throws you in for a few quick rounds, you're not going to get good at boxing like that, you know. You need to be comfortable and relaxed when you're sparring. Like, it's natural. And the way that we do it is we're doing 30-minute spar, 35-minute spar, and at a certain point, Nathan, my sparring partner, he gets tired. And that's good, because in a fight, you might get adversary. You know what I mean? So, And you need to be able to overcome that. So if you're doing, like, 30, 35-minute long spars, you're going to get tired, and you keep going, you stay strong. And you get second wind, and you know what I mean? You get comfortable, you learn how to be more efficient with your energy, you know? If you're going to have to last 30 minutes, you need to be able to relax and not waste so much energy. There's so many benefits to it. I'm not telling you just to do 30-minute spars. I'm telling you to make sure that every week you're doing a lot of sparring, okay? 2-3 days a week sparring if you want to be really good at boxing, okay? But you don't have to try and kill each other there, you know? You just need to go at a pace. It's not as hard as a fight, you know. You're not hitting each other as hard, but you're focusing on technique, you're relaxing, and you're getting as much rounds in as you can, okay? So, also, it's good to spar people that are better than you, so you've got something to strive to improve and to step your game up. But it's good to spar some people that aren't as good as you, because now you can try some other skills and tricks that you wouldn't take that chance against someone that's better than you, you know? So, I mean, you can try practicing some defensive shoulder rolls, or you can work on footwork and angles, or something that you don't normally work on, because if you do, you're going to get punched by someone that's better than you. Well, now you can try working all that, and once you get good at working all that and finding what works, you can do that against someone that's better than you, because you'll pull it off, because you've got the muscle memory for it, okay? So, sparring is key to boxing, guys. Make sure you're doing it every day. You don't have to kill each other, just relax, get the time in, get the rounds in. Thank your sparring partners for getting the rounds in. It's win-win. Iron sharpens iron, okay? That's it, make sure you're sparring, guys. Oh.
It's not illegal.
No, it's not.
You can feel the power in the arm. Yeah. I'm just...
I'll
try and keep it sharp.
Oh shit. Oh.
Oh!